Today, class, before we start our lesson, let's have a short prayer.
Dear Lord,
hello class, I am Mr. Jasper Jan Egolia, your teacher in Technology and Livelihood Education, or you can call me Sir Jasper. So for today, we are going to discuss the different electrical signs and symbols used in electrical installation and maintenance. But before we proceed, who among you remembered our lesson last time? Very good! It is all about mensuration and calculation. Before we proceed to our discussion, let's have a review first. So what is mensuration? How do you convert English measurement to the metric system? And vice versa. And what is the best possible way to do that? Yes, when we say mensuration, it is the act of measuring something. It follows the system of measurement that can be used to specify something or anything that can be measured. The metric system and English system is also called as the imperial system of mensuration or measurements. These are both common systems that we use today. The best way to convert this each other is to be familiarized with the list of some of the conversions or relationships between the imperial and metric system units. So it is like this one. The English units and each equivalent. The metric units and each equivalent. And the English to metric equivalent. Next, what do you call the device that can measure voltage, resistance, and current? Yes, it is called the multi-tester or multimeter. Is also sometimes called as VOM or the voltmeter, ohmmeter, and milliammeter. It is the best instrument that can measure voltage, resistance, and current. It is generally made of two types. What are those? The analog and the digital. And it looks like this one. Very good. Now that you are already familiar with this topic, let's now proceed to our next lesson. Are you ready? Okay, let's go. Imagine that we are along the road. Oops! Remember to stay only on the sidewalk to avoid accidents. Since we are here outside, what have you observed around us? What do you think are those things attached to a pole? Very good! They are called signs, or road signs to be exact. We often see these signs along the road. What does this tell us? These signs or warning signs are pictograms or picture symbols intended to alert us. It specifies situations which, if avoided, will result to minor or serious injury. Signs are not usually used in road alone. In building an establishment, we commonly use signs that contain warnings on a particular situation like the caution, danger, high voltage, and the likes. And these signs is what we call electrical signs. Okay? Let's now go home and continue our discussion. I know that you are already in your room. Have you seen any bulb or outlets right there? If there is, can you count the bulbs and the outlets? How many are there? Do you know that there are corresponding symbols for each of them? If yes, can you draw one? For example, can you draw the symbol of a bulb? Wow, very nice. We often draw a bulb like this one. But in the world of electricity, this particular drawing is not used and prefer this one. Why? Because this is the symbol of a bulb that is universal and standard. This topic will help us to be familiar with the different signs and symbols used in electrical installation and maintenance. Specifically, you are tasked to identify the common electrical signs and symbols, analyze its electrical components and materials, and interpret technical plans and drawings. The signs and symbols play a very important role in our society. As we said a while ago, it prevents us in the upcoming danger and guide us on what to do. On the road, we have road signs that usually alert us on the particular dangers. In malls, airports, restaurants, and other establishments, we usually look for a signage that will lead us to the comfort room, the kitchen, the entrances, and the exits. Thus, these signs and symbols serve as our guide. In this lesson, we are going to explore the different signs and symbols in wiring diagram. These signs and symbols are usually found in the appliances, switches, wire boxes, and other electrical devices. So are you ready? Yes, let's start. Do you know any electrician on your area? If yes, have you seen an electrical plan used by that particular electrician? What are the details in that plan? I have here an example of a plan. Let's try to analyze it. Now, can you count the number of bulbs right there? Very good. Keep your answers and we will check that later. When we say electrical symbols, these are small drawings or pictograms used to represent various electrical devices in a diagram or a plan of an electrical circuit. Any electrical fixture found in a house has a symbol that represents them in an electrical plan, like the lamp, speakers, switches, outlets, and the like. These are also a useful guide for an electrician or electrical contractor in making the wiring easier to install. So the following are the common electrical symbols used in sketching wiring diagrams and plans. First is this one. This is what we call electrical wire. So we have these wire symbols. We have here the conductor or wire. It is used to connect components in a circuit. So these are the conductors that transmit electricity from a source, specifically from a transformer, to an outlet in our home. So most electrical fixtures have wires. And it has different sizes. So this is an example of a wire that is connected to each other, or what we call the wire splice. And this is the example or the symbol when they are not. Next are the switch symbols. The common symbol of a switch is like this. If we will use it in a wiring diagram. And we use this symbol if we use it in an electrical plan. So this is an example of a one-gang switch. Why? It is called one-gang because it has only one switch. And this is what we call a three-gang switch because it has three switches. Switches are devices for making or breaking the connection in an electrical circuit. The common power supply symbols are that of a cell and a battery. A cell is a single unit of device which converts chemical energy into an electrical energy. It is usually light and compact, and it has single unit only. It can be either dry, wet, or fuel types, depends on the electrolytes used. On the other hand, when we say battery, it consists of group of cells. Most commonly, it has 6 single cells. It can be a primary or secondary battery, meaning it can be rechargeable or non-rechargeable. The difference between these two is that a cell supply power for a short time only, while battery can supply power for a very long time. A cell is most commonly used in the clocks, lamp, and others which requires low energy. And a battery is most likely used in automobiles, inverters, and others. But both can store chemical energy, then converts it into an electrical energy. Next is the antenna. Antenna is an electrical device which converts electric power into radio waves and vice versa. We commonly see this antenna in radios and televisions which signal is transmitted by radio waves. Next, we have the resistor symbol. A resistor reduces or limits the current flow. So appliances such as electrical heaters, ovens, and toasters are all use resistors to turn current into a heat. Next is the capacitor symbol. A capacitor is used to store electric charge. Since it stored electric charge, so capacitors are used in smartphones, household appliances, electric vehicles, and others. This is an example of a capacitor. Next, we have the meter symbols. And the first on the list is the ammeter. An ammeter is a measuring instrument used to measure current in a circuit. Next is the voltmeter. A voltmeter is used to measure voltage in a circuit. So this is an example of a voltmeter. Next, we have the galvanometer. A galvanometer is an electromechanical measuring instrument for electric current. So this is its symbol and example. Next one, we have the wattmeter. Wattmeter is an instrument for making the electric power or the supply rate of electrical energy in watts of any given circuit. This is its symbol and example. And lastly, we have the kilowatt hour meter. This is an electric meter that measures the amount of electrical energy in kilowatt hour that was consumed in our house. It is the rounded thing that we usually see outside of our home. It is the electrical company reads to determine our electrical consumption. Next are the outlet symbols. An electrical outlet is a socket that connects an electrical device to an electrical supply. First, we have the duplex convenience outlet, which is a receptacle in a wall or baseboard for connection of lamps or other electrical appliances. It is called duplex because it has 2 sockets. Next one, we have the weatherproof outlet. A weatherproof outlet is a particular type of electrical outlet that is designed for installation outside of our home. It is called weatherproof because it has this thing that protects the socket from rains and sun. And lastly, we have the floor outlet. A floor outlet is whose face is level with the floor, hence its name, floor outlet. Next on the list is one of the greatest inventions of all time. It is the bulb or the lamp. wherein it generates light when electricity passes through it. Examples of this are the incandescent lamp, light bulb, and the fluorescent lamp. Lastly, we have the miscellaneous symbols used in wiring diagrams and electrical plants. We have here the MEL plug. It is an electrical device with two or three pins that is inserted in a socket to make an electrical connection. It can be seen in a wide range of appliances. This is an example of a MEL plug, and this is a socket. We usually insert this MEL plug into the socket so that a particular device, we can use it using electricity. Next is the fuse. A fuse is an electrical safety device that is used to protect circuit from high currents. Next one, we have the circuit breakers. A circuit breaker is an automatically operated electrical switch designed to protect an electrical circuit from a damage caused by excess amount or current from an overload or short circuit. Its basic function is to interrupt current flow after a fault is detected. It is mostly seen inside our home. We turn off this thing when we experience a power outage. So this is an example of a circuit breaker. Next, we have the buzzer. A buzzer is a kind of voice device that converts audio model into a sound signal. It is mainly used to prompt or alarm. And lastly, we have the speaker. The speaker is a device that converts electrical energy into an acoustical signal energy that is radiated into a room or the open air. So these are the common symbols used in electrical wiring diagrams and plans. Let's now move on to the next one, the electrical sign. Electrical signs, on the other hand, alert students, workers, visitors to any electrical hazards in the area. It contains a warning icon intended to alert or instruct you to avoid a potentially hazardous condition. Knowing and understanding these signs will help you to operate your tools better and more safely. Next, we have the caution. A caution indicates some precautionary measures against potential situation or hazardous situation, which, if avoided, may result to minor or serious injury. Next, are you familiar with this one? It is what we call safety alert. It indicates that a person should observe extra caution or extra awareness. Next one is a prohibition. It means that any activity is not allowed as stated by that symbol. Next one, I know all of us are familiar with these two signs, the danger and the warning. This danger and warning signs specifies potentially hazardous situation which, if avoided, may result to minor or serious injury or even death. Next one, we have the read and understand instruction manual. It means that a person should make some reading before doing any activity. Next, we need to wear eye protection. This is its symbol. It indicates that a person should wear safety goggles or any related protection to the eyes. Next, we have the electrical hazard. It indicates that electrical hazard is present in that area. Lastly, we have the voltage danger. It indicates high voltage in the area and surrounding equipment. These are the common electrical signs and symbols that we usually encounter. Now that we are already familiar with this, let's try to analyze again the electrical plan that we have seen a while ago. Okay, so we have here the electrical plan again. Present here are the symbols of a ceiling-mounted light, a recessed light, wall-mounted light, fan, duplex receptacle outlet, or the duplex convenience outlet, a telephone outlet, a switch, a dimmer switch, and a doorbell. Now, let's check your answers a while ago. For the first question, we have how many bulbs are there? What's your answer? It has 16 bulbs, including all the ceiling-mounted, wall-mounted, and recessed lights. Okay? Next, I have here new questions for you. How many duplex convenience outlets are there? Very good! There are 7 duplex convenience outlets. Lastly, are there any doorbells present in the plan? How many are there? Yes, it only has 1 doorbell outside of the house. Very good, and I hope that you are now ready for our activity. I want you to show your understanding by doing this activity. So the direction is fill out the grid with at least 5 electrical symbols and write their description. And the next activity is you need to draw 5 electrical signs of the following. So you have 5 minutes and your timer starts now. Time's up! Okay, so let's try to check your answers. So what's your score?
Thank you.
So what's your score? Wow! Congratulations! It seems that you already mastered our lesson. So again, what are the common electrical signs and symbols that we use in electrical plant? Yes, we have the conductor or wire. We have a switch, a cell, battery, antenna, resistor, capacitor, ammeter, voltmeter, galvanometer, wattmeter, kilowatt hour, mail plug, fuse, circuit breaker, electric bell, buzzer, speaker, duplex convenience outlet, weatherproof outlet, floor outlet, incandescent lamp, light or lamp bulb, and a fluorescent lamp. How about the electrical signs? We have here the caution, the safety alert, the prohibition, danger, warning, read and understand instruction manual, wear eye protection, electrical hazard, and voltage danger. So when do we use the symbols? Yes, electrical symbols are used to simplify the drawing and to understand the drawing. Electrical symbols are standardized throughout the industry. The addition of a line, dot, shading, letters, and numbers give specific meaning to a symbol. So in order to achieve the ability to interpret the drawings and their related symbol meanings, we need or we must learn the basic form of various symbols. Next, how important do you think the symbols are in an electrician? Yes, electrical symbols are required to do the electrical drawing, and without the help of electrical symbols, we won't be able to do electrical drawing. Electrical drawings can be used to convey information to a wide range of details such as electrical wiring, location of the equipment, and details of the equipment. By using electrical drawings, we would be able to locate the equipment. I am very proud of you. It seems that you really understand our lesson. For our last activity, can you count the number of electrical fixtures and then write your answers on a separate sheet of paper? I will be giving you another 5 minutes to do this activity. Your timer starts now. Time's up! To check your answers, can you take a picture of your work and send it to our Facebook Messenger group chat? And for your assignment, I want you to get your notebook and copy the instructions. So using the symbols that you have studied, draw the electrical plan of the living room in your house on a sheet of paper. Specifically, use bond paper. And use the rubric as your guide. And that's it for our lesson for today. I hope that you learned something from our discussion that you will apply someday if you wish to be an electrician. Always remember to stay safe and stay at home. Again, I am Mr. Jasper Janay Golia, your teacher in technology and livelihood education. See you next meeting. Goodbye!